Doctor Who. On the plain outside the ancient city of Troy, two men are fighting.
Achilles!
Over here, stable keeper, barbarian horse worshipper.
Out of breath so soon, my light-foot princeling.
Your friend Patroclus fled me farther and made better sports.
Murderer! Patroclus with a boy! A boy? Well, he died like a dog, whimpering after his master, Achilles. Come, let me send you to him where he waits in Hades. Let me throw the dog a bone or two.
Achilles lunges at Hector, who easily parries the thrust. They circle round each other warily.
What? So anxious to be gone? I would not keep you for the world.
Bones would be the meatier Trojan, though meat a trifle like the fat. Well, all's one. They were whitened well enough in the sun.
Enraged, Achilles attacks again, and Hector counters every blow. Hector seems to be gaining the upper hand when Achilles turns and dodges out of reach, running past and ignoring the blue police box, which has no place in the middle of a Trojan plain. Hector follows, calling after him.
Run, Achilles! Run! Run a little more before you die!
The Mythmakers by Donald Cotton. Episode 1, Temple of Secrets.
What sort of people are they, Doctor?
Oh, I'm not sure, my child. You'll notice they're wearing Grecian costumes.
They don't seem to have noticed us.
You want the point?
That's hardly surprising in the circumstances.
Not even to
Why do you suppose they're fighting?
The I haven't the remotest idea, my boy. No doubt their reasons will be entirely adequate.
Yes, I think I... Perhaps I'd better go and ask them where they are.
Doctor, be careful. They are terribly fierce.
Oh, what nonsense. If you take notice of them, I think they're doing more talking than they are fighting. I think I'd better go and ask them where they are.
Doctor, you can't. You know if you go out there by yourself...
Now, you stay here, my dear, and look after that ankle.
Wouldn't it be better if I went?
Not at all, young man. You stay here and keep an eye on Vicky. Besides, I don't think your present humour is fitting for the occasion. You know, I don't think they'd appreciate your kind of sarcasm.
The gods of my people, Hector, are not lightly mocked. They are terrible. And Troy itself is doomed to fall at their bidding. Even as you are. You cannot stand against them.
You pretend that old Father Zeus will descend to earth and take Troy for you. I guarantee to trim his beard for him if he dare attempt it.
Beware. The voice of Zeus, Hector. Beware the anger of Olympus.
Who am I to fear the thunder, you superstitious, dart-dodging decadent? Hear me, Zeus. Accept from me the promised light of your cringing servant, Achilles. Or else, I challenge you. Descend to earth and save him!
Hector lunges at Achilles as the Doctor emerges from the TARDIS, and Hector falls to his knees, amazed.
Zeus!
With Hector distracted, Achilles runs him through with his sword.
Stop! You must not kick a man when he is down. You have killed this poor fellow.
Oh, but in your name?
In my name, indeed. Get up! Get up, I tell you! This is terrible.
If Zeus bids me to rise...
What is this? What is it you take me for?
The father of the gods and ruler of the world.
What? Do you really? And who might you be, may I ask?
Achilles. Mightiest of warriors, greatest in battle, humblest of your servants.
Well, if I may say so, you're not very humble, are you, eh? Yes, I think I know you, yes. And this friend of yours must be...
Hector, Prince of Troy. Sent to Hades for blasphemy against the gods of Greece.
Blasphemy? I'm sure he didn't mean it.
He threatened to trim your beard should you descend to earth.
Oh, did he now? Well, if you notice, I have no beard.
If you had appeared to me in your true form, I would have been truly blinded by your radiance. It is well known that when you come amongst us, you adopt to many different forms.
Oh, do I?
To Europa, you appear as a bull. To Leda, as a swan. To me, in the guise of an old beggar.
I beg your pardon, I do nothing of the kind.
Oh, but still your glory shines through.
Oh, indeed, indeed so. Yes, so I should hope. Yes, well, thank you. I'm glad to meet you. Now, if you will excuse me, I must get back to my temple. Attend to his funeral.
Oh, stop! You must not go.
Do you realize whom you are addressing?
Forgive me, Father Zeus. I spoke hastily.
Then do not hinder me, or I will strike you with a thunderbolt.
I must brave even the wrath of Zeus and implore you to remain.
Well, I don't see why I should. I have many other commitments, you must understand.
And one of them lies here, in the camp of Agamemnon, our general. Oh, hear me out, I pray. For 10 long years now, we have laid siege to Troy, and still they defy us. Come.
In the TARDIS, Vicky and Stephen watch on the scanner as Achilles leads the Doctor to the top of a ridge.
Where's he off to now? That's a fine time to go looking at the view.
After all, that's why he went out there, to find out where we are. Anyway, that man looks quite friendly now. He's probably showing him the way to the nearest town.
I wonder. I think I'd better try and find some more suitable clothes.
There they sit, secure behind their walls, whilst we rot in their summers and starve in their crackbone winters.
The Doctor and Achilles' gaze upon the distant walled city is disturbed by the arrival of Odysseus, King of Ithaca, accompanied by a group of soldiers.
What's this, Achilles? So far from camp, all unprotected from a prisoner?
Odysseus, this is no prisoner.
Certainly not. Not yet a prisoner. You should have called for assistance, lad. We would not like to lose you. Come, let us escort you homewards. Night might fall and find thee from thy tent.
I wouldn't stand for that if I were you.
Ah, but then, O fellow, you are not the Lord Achilles. He is not the one to look for trouble, are you, boy?
Never care, pirate. Are there no Trojan throats to slit that you dare tempt my sword?
Throats enough, I grant you. Some half-score Trojans will not whistle easy tonight, but what of you?
Oh, but a trifle. I met Prince Hector. Here he lies.
Zeus!
Was instrumental.
No doubt, no doubt. But what a year this is for plague. Even the strongest might fall. Prince Hector, huh, that he should come to this. You met him here, you say, as he lay dying.
I met him, Odysseus, in single combat.
Oh, yes, it's true.
And raced him round the walls till down he fell exhausted. A famous victory.
I met him face to face, I say. Battled with him for an hour or more. Until my greater strength overcame him.
Bravo! But tell me, Lightfoot, what of Zeus? You say he intervened, and then...
Why, there he stands, and listens to your mockery.
Oh, yes, I find it most interesting. What? This old man, this red-bagged, gray-bagged. Oh, come, Achilles.
Oh, forgive him, Father Zeus. He is but a rough and simple sailor.
Aye, very rough, but scarce as simple as you seem to think. What have we here?
Odysseus approaches the TARDIS to examine it.
Stephen! He's coming in.
No, the Doctor will stop him. I must go out and help.
No, don't. Just a minute. Here. Take this and wait behind the door. Hmm?
The Temple of Zeus, you say? A trifle modest, is it not, for so powerful a god?
This is my travelling temple. Being small, it's convenient.
You shall not enter.
Certainly not. In any case, I must be off.
Oh, then will you not stay with us?
No, I...
What? You will to the Grecian camp. If you indeed be Zeus, we have need of your assistance. Now, do not cower there, lads. Zeus is on our side, so Agamemnon keeps insisting... Bear him up and let us carry him in triumph to the camp.
I am quite capable of walking.
Odysseus, I claim the honor to escort him. Let him walk to camp with me.
You shall have honor enough. Maybe we shall have a little of the truth. Father Zeus, we await you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.